Hello, my name is Shawn Conley. I'm the State Soybean and Small Grains Extension Specialist at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Today we're going to talk about some challenges related to soil crusting and the impact on the resultant yield. One of the challenges that we've seen across the Midwest over the last 10 years are these less frequent, more intense rainfalls that are occurring and leading to more compaction type crusting type issues. So what we want to do today is discuss some of the things you can look at while we assess stand and what the resultant yield impact would be. Now, as we understand with soybean, we'll kind of walk us through the entire process of germination. Now, this is a plant right here that is at the VC growth stage. As we can see, the cotyledons have emerged, the unifoliates have emerged, and this plant is in very good shape to be able to go through and maximize yield. As we go along this line here, we can see a progression of different injury resulting from crusting. This plant right here, as we can see, a couple things have happened to it. First of all, we see this intense swelling of the hypocotyl, as well as some challenges with the hypocotyl being twisted. This was resulting of a pressure being exuded on the hypocotyl to try and push the cotyledons through, or I should say pull the cotyledons through the soil surface. One of the things we can see here is that these unifoliates are light in color, pale green. That would be a resulting of that plant actually starting to leaf out underneath the soil surface. Now that it has emerged, we'll be able to see photosynthesis occur. The plant right next to it, however, or the next four, have seen the fact that the cotyledons have completely broken. And one of the challenges we can see with that is that soybean uses epigeal emergence, which basically says that when the cotyledons come above the soil surface, the growing point is then above that soil surface. At this point, we can see that the neck or hypocotyl is broken below any of the meristems. We have zero yield potential. This plant is effectively dead. One of the questions we always have is what happens if we lose a cotyledon or two cotyledons, and what would that do to our resulting yield impact? So if we look at a soybean plant like this, and we would lose one cotyledon during the germination process, we would effectively have 0% yield loss at this point. If we were to lose both cotyledons at this point and all we were stuck with was our unifoliate leaf, depending on where you are in the Midwest, we would see anywhere from a 2 to 7% yield loss. A 2% yield loss would be in the southern part of say Illinois, Missouri, Indiana. As you move further north, we would see more yield loss due to the loss of both cotyledons. We'd be approaching that 7% yield loss. And that basically comes to the fact that we are having a shorter growing season, and the time frame it would take for the soybean plant to reach full maturity would be significantly delayed, and that would be the compounding impact of that yield loss. For more information on soybean germination, emergence, or stand issues, feel free to follow me at BadgerBean or go to www.coolbean.info.